Selamat petang puan, nama saya Izzy. Saya pelajar tahun akhir Fakulti Perubatan lah. Jadi hari ini saya akan buat pemeriksaan skin ke bahagian leher puan. Sebelum tu boleh saya tahu puan selesa ke sekarang?
Puan selesa. Okay.
Puan ada sakit mana-mana tak?
Masa ada.
Sepanjang pemeriksaan ni saya akan lihatlah ke bahagian leher dan saya akan pegang sikit lah. Sepanjang pemeriksaan ni kalau saya buat puan rasa tak selesa atau sakit, saya boleh tahu saya. On general examination, patient is sitting comfortably. Look whether the patient has any in obvious skin or in any respiratory distress. And by this inspecting, look thoroughly whether the patient is having fracture asymmetry. And then proceed to local examination. So let's just pretend that this patient is having right submandibular swelling. So yeah, puan eh?
Okay.
So by just inspecting, we can see that this patient is having right submandibular swelling, and look, the swelling is at the posterior inferior to the earlobe, and if it is large enough, it can extend anterior to the earlobe, and it can deviate the earlobe laterally, and not to forget to look at the retromandibular area. If it is parotid swelling, it will obliterate this space. Okay. And then by inspection, see whether the swelling has overlying skin changes such as erythematous to suggest inflammation or infection, and look whether there is a discharge coming out from the swelling. And then proceed to palpation. Saya akan mula memegang ya puan.
Okay, boleh.
Okay. Palpate for tenderness and look at the patient's face. See with palpate for warmth. Mm. And then look at the patient's face. Look whether the patient is having a tenderness and outline the mass first by palpating the surface of the mass, whether it is smooth surface or lobulated, and then look for consistency of the mass, whether it is soft, firm or hard inconsistency, and then feel for the margin of the mass, whether it is well defined or irregular margin, and to assess fixity of the mass, ask the patient to clench her teeth. Puan boleh ketatkan gigi.
Okay.
Yeah. Move the mass horizontally to check whether it is fixed to the underlying masseter muscles. Okay, dah puannya. Okay. And then look whether the mass is attached to the overlying skin by pinching the skin.
Okay.
And then after done with the swelling, proceed with lymph node examination. First saya akan rasa sikit ya.
Okay, okay.
Puan boleh tunggu sikit. Palpate for first for the submental lymph node, then submandibular lymph node, post auricular lymph node, pre auricular lymph node, suboccipital lymph node, posterior cervical lymph node, and anterior cervical lymph node, and then supraclavicular lymph node. After complete with general examination and local examination and lymph node examination, I would like to complete my examination with asking the patient to open her mouth to look whether the patient has strabismus, and inspect the oral cavity to look for the medialization of the lateral pharyngeal wall, and opening of the Stenson duct to see whether there is any past discharge or bloody discharge. And not to forget, lastly, is to do facial nerve examination.